It is 5 o'clock, and you can see how windy it already is out there. We're taking a live look now at Sacramento International Airport, one of our Skycams from the Skycam 3 network. We've got a red flag warning in effect, and Northern California is still on high alert, watching out for fire dangers.
Good morning. Welcome back. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Walt Gray.
And I'm Deirdre Fitzpatrick. We had a series of wildfires that have been keeping fire crews and our crews busy across Northern California.
Almost 100 structures have been destroyed in the three largest fires in Butte County near Ophir Road, along Jackson Road in Sacramento County, and in Stockton, where the city saw one of its worst fires ever.
We've got live team coverage for you on the fires.
Let's start with KCRA3's Brian Hickey, who's in Butte County. Brian, what's happening up there right now?
Well, we're just about 2 miles south of the town of Oroville, in a place where 21 homes burned yesterday, 28 outbuildings in this fire that is now 1,600 acres and has been 50% contained. Fire crews have said that overnight, though, the fire has not grown in size. They've stopped the front of the fire, and now it's just a bunch of smoldering hot spots and concerns for fire crews overnight. What you're seeing here live is an old olive packing plant that someone had recently purchased and converted into a junkyard, an indoor junkyard, as described by one neighbor. And you can see out here this morning, smoldering tires left and just piles of melted metal all left behind by this fire yesterday. Take a look at some video from yesterday, a fire that was fueled by 40-mile-per-hour winds. And as we took a look at some of the aerials from Live Copter 3 yesterday, you could really see how this fire hopscotched around. And that's why it was such a tough fire for crews to get their hands around, as it was jumping embers, pushed ahead by these 40-mile-per-hour winds, really moving this thing along. And again, 21 homes burned, 28 outbuildings lost, 99 vehicles burned up, 500 people evacuated. What we're told, though, no one injured in this fire, and there is an evacuation center set up at the Church of the Nazarene, although one neighbor that we spoke to just about 30 minutes ago tells us that a lot of the neighbors have come back into the area to see what is left. And again, back out here live, just look at the rubble left behind from this old olive packing plant. In fact, right over here, look at this, a fiberglass jet boat, gone, just melted to the ground. Right here, some melted aluminum, looks like an icicle almost on the ground. You can see that there, nothing left of it. If there's any good news here this morning, I know when we left Sacramento and you're reporting the winds down there right now, here in Butte County, looking at our anemometer here, 2-mile-an-hour wind, so really no wind, just a light breeze at this point. But again, still under a red flag warning up here. There have been fire crews in this neighborhood all night long monitoring the situation. And you'll hear from one neighbor coming up in the next half hour, Jim Cantrell, who lives just on the other side, right through those trees over there. He's out looking for a fire crew right now, as some hot spots have already started to smolder in his backyard, and he's concerned about those and would really like to get somebody over there to mop those up before the winds pick up any further throughout the morning. Live in Butte County, just outside of Oroville, I'm Brian Hickey. Back to you.
Brian, thank you.
In Sacramento County, fire crews are still on the scene of a grass fire that jumped across several roads.
That's where one firefighter was seriously hurt fighting flames. KCRA3's Leticia Ordaz has more.
This has been a devastating fire here off of Jackson and Excelsior Roads in Sacramento County. So far, 10 structures have burned, including two homes. 6,400 acres burned to the ground, leaving cattle and horses without a place to call home. A firefighter was also injured during this firefight. He's actually at the UC Davis Med Center. He has severe burns, and we're told it's going to be a very long recovery ahead. Investigators are still trying to figure out the cause of this fire. At this point, they say they are not ruling out arson. In Sacramento County, I'm Leticia Ordaz, KCRA 3 reports.
If you have any information on this fire, you're urged to call the arson tip line, 916-566-4320.
And there are some voluntary evacuations in Tuolumne County for another grass fire.
This one started late last night by the Lake Don Pedro area. Firefighters say the fire jumped the Tuolumne River by the Don Pedro Dam. So far, the fire has burned 1,200 acres and two structures. The fire is only 30% contained.
And fire crews were also very busy yesterday with a grass fire. This one near Latrobe Road in El Dorado County. It was south of Highway 50. Fire burned into part of the Grace Foundation Ranch. That's an organization that works both with rescued animals and special needs kids. And they were working with autistic children at the time. They had to evacuate everybody. The foundation is now keeping an eye out for any flare-ups.
This morning, fire crews in Stockton are watching for flare-ups. Yesterday, a fire in the Quail Lakes area destroyed 24 condos, burning 9 homes. Every Stockton firefighter on and off duty was called out to battle this one. Two firefighters were hurt. Investigators say it started near the freeway. They're still looking into the actual cause. This morning, residents will return home to see what's left.